My name is Maryam Firdaus. I'm 33 years old. I'm a physician, diver since 2002, living in Mecca, basically. The idea started 2008. It was like a hobby. I like the sea, and at this time there was a Jeddah crisis about the rain. So I decided since that time to become a professional diver, not only a diver, a professional one. This is my start. Actually, I know many people, but for me, I wasn't sure that in my country people can dive. I mean, at that time, 2008. But after that, I know many people, and I'm really, really very happy to know them. So I can say they inspire me. I have like many names, but unfortunately I don't have the name now. My first scuba it was in 2008, and I was like 25 years old, and my buddy was I remember them. Umran, he was 15 years old, and Lily, she was 10 years old. So I was like a big person with the kids, and I feel how much time I lost. These kids can enjoy the sea, and for me, I cannot. I just start into when my age is 25. So this is my first one, and I was still struggling with the rope, with the instructor. With his order, and I saw him how they swim and dive smoothly. So I was really, really, I was feeling so shame. How many years I lost without enjoying this and doing this this dive things. Actually, there was a list for us. As I told you, it was a team, 20 people, and our idea basically that we wanna dive in abnormal places. So North Pole, it was our last choice. But when we go there, I mean, when we start the training in Russia, we change our priority from the last place to the first place. So this is why we are choosing the North Pole, because we like to dive in a new place and express and show a new place. So this is our idea. When I told them, it was like it's a funny things, and I will I'll tell you about this funny story. I don't know if you know Raha Al-Muharrad or not. She is the first Saudi climbing the Everest mountain. It was 2011, and she was in TV show, and me and my mother watching this episode. Then I asked my mother, if I did something like her, something crazy like her, would you support me or you will stop me? And she said, if it's things and with no harm, yeah, why not? So I told her, okay. At that time, I wasn't preparing or thinking about the North Pole. But when the idea I can see fully matured or fully planned, I came to her and I asked. I told her, do you remember that talk when we talked, and you said you will support me? Now you have to support me. I want to go to the North Pole. And she said, did I say that? I told her, yes, you said that. And there is a many people are there. So what you said? She said, okay. Are you sure it's not her? I told her, yeah. Don't worry, I will be fine. I will be okay. Really, I wasn't lying, but I don't know. It was an honest talk. So she support me about my friend, about my family. All of them are supporting me. I mean, many people not accepted the idea that women and go there by herself alone with the strange guys. How she can cope? How she can deal with them? Because I'm dealing daily in my duty, in my work with the strange people. So this things make me strong. So they support me because they know how I am. So this is the support things. Yes, I got a lot of this, especially in the from the social media, and even many people are start to talking to my family how you are leaving your daughter or your sister like this. You have to stop her. It's a free things, and we are not Libyan people, so we are coming from Mecca. So you have to be the real Muslim, and this is not to represent Islam and this idea. Yeah, for the diving, it start, as I told you, it's since long time, 2008. So I was saving some of my salary for that. And even this saving is helping me with the North Pole. After that, we went to we took a lion and other family support. So also we got some funds from non-profit organization. They are supporting the youth people and the women, especially the women. So this is about the funding for the North Pole. The preparation, it takes like an 18 month. We start with the diving in the Russia. We took two course, the ice diving and the dry suit diving. It takes 1 month. Then after that, they give us the licenses. When we go back to the Saudi Arabia, there was a requirement for the North Pole. So I mean we dive here in Jeddah with the dry suit. Then after that, we went again to Russia for this preparation. So it took like 18 months. Between preparation for that, and even I got like a physical training here because I have to be physically fit, and there is an ideal weight, and I'm an underweight, so I have to build my body for that. So this also take like an 18 month for that. Yeah, actually, I did like a workshop, and I consult a special office in UK. They are specialized in giving this type of consultation. So they give me a medical instructors about how to save your health. And how to be medically fit, how to be physically fit. So they are training me and giving me like I was trained for 6 months, and they were watching me like every month. They are taking my measure and they give me a special regimen for diet. So it takes like 6 months to prepare for this. The trip takes around 45 days. March 28th, we was flying from Jeddah. 2016, we flying from Jeddah to Paris, then from Paris to Russia. We stay there in Karelia. which is a separate federal state at the border with the Finland. We took our preparation there, our final preparation there. We spent there like 2 weeks. Then after that, we are taking a flying to the Norway. We spend in Oslo in Tromsø for 2 days. Then after that, we went to Svalbard Island, which is a big island in the north, which is the last place people can live there. After that, it's an ocean, it's a North Pole, so nobody can watch there. We stay there for 2 weeks, waiting for our flight and for the weather condition, because it was a really bad condition. After that, we took a special flight, which is a military and aircraft. It's AN-74. They took us from the Svalbard Island to the North Pole, to the real North Pole, and there was a unique ice camp supported and funded by the Russian government, which they called it Pyrenees Ice Camp. We stayed there almost for 2 days. Then after that, by helicopter, they took us to the real North Pole, to the geographic North Pole, where the 90 degree. We spent there for 5 days, between establish our camp, between preparation for the dive, and 1 day or 2 day wait after we finish our mission. We spent 2 days more because the weather was so bad, so the helicopter cannot come and take us. After that, we stay in Pyrenees also for 2 days. Then in Svalbard another 10 days. Then we came. So totally, it was a 45 days, the whole trip. Yeah, if you take the Russian the visa, you will get the support. But really, really, I can say it was so hard to get there. I mean, in the Russian territory. Because they have a doubt about our program. We are Saudi, and we are going there in Russia for diving. So they was asking us a lot in the border. Are you sure you came here for diving? And we said yes, we came here for diving. So we stayed in the border between 7 to 10 to 10 hours. We spent there just to clarify from the company that we are that arrange everything about really, really, are we going there for a diving or for something else, and to see how we are dealing with the guard there, if we are how we can deal with them. And we was like, we want to go there. So if you are keeping 10 hours, 10 days, we are staying there, and we want to reach our goal. After we reached the North Pole, it was like an ice desert, nothing there except the ice. So we have to establish our camp. So we start to digging the ice to build the tent. We built like a 3 tent, and we put it like in a cave, because you know the weather and the wind, it come from different direction. So we have to put the tent in a cave. So we start to dig the ice. After that we start to build the to cut the mainer, which is the hole to dive. We cut like a three mainer. The primary one, it's for diving, but the other two, it's for emergency case, because you know when you dive, there is a special way. It's not like a normal sea. You can if the water is if there is any emergency, you can come up and and you will find and you can see your origin place where you died. It's a totally covered place, and you have only these three halls. So the process there, there is a two people dive. One is a watcher, and the other one is taking care about the area. If there is a wild animals, if there is the water is not enough. I mean, we need the hot water because one of the common things we facing in the ice condition, it's the freezing for the regulator, which is the source of the air. So you need the hot water to clear this freezing. So this water is, as I told you, it's 6 hours. So you need this water to be enough for the diver. I mean for the two who dives, and even for the guard who secure the miners. After that, we talked like a rest about the sleeping. It was we divide ourselves to two teams. First team, me and one of my instructor, which his name is Konstantin, and the other two, Hussam and Ivan, they should be awake because anytime the wild animal may come, the peers may come and attacking us, so they have to be aware. And when we are awake, they got to sleep, and we do this so on. So we divide our day to 8 hours, 8 hours for sleeping, 8 hours for gardening other people, and 8 hours to do our job. I mean our mission, preparing the water and this stuff. My last day, it was so funny because as I told you, there was 2 days we are freezing and waiting for the helicopter to come and take us. So we was like we are freezing in a tent, and the weather is -40, and there is no source of heat, only you and your blanket. So when they give us the call. It was a satellite phone. They call us and they said after 3 hours we will came. So you have to pack everything. So at that time our instructor Ivan, he told us, okay, we will teach you some tradition, Russian tradition, and you have to show us or dancing or celebrating by your Arabic way. So we made an Arabic coffee. I took with me an Arabic coffee, and I wear my abaya, and my partner Hussam, he wearing his top and put his shumar, and yes, and we talk and we go outside and start to doing an Arabic dance, which is in our region, you know, Saudi Arabia is a many region. So in Western region, they know about mizmar. So we put a song. In a mobile, then we start to dancing by the Arabic by mizmar way, and for them they was like really Ivan and Konstantin, they said we told them we have a deal, we will show our Arabic tradition and you have to show us your Russian tradition, and they told us we don't usually in this case. We bring a vodka and that's it. This is our celebration. This is our Russian celebration. So here there is no vodka. So we are only dancing with you. We took like a half an hour for doing this. Then we pack everything we pack. I mean in our bag. We waiting for. We put a sign. Just to make easy for the helicopter to see our place, then they talk us. The helicopter, when I was there, I was like in a shock. Is this real? One week before I was in a normal place. I mean, I was in Savalabart, but it's everything is here. There is a, I mean everything. So is it real or I just was a dreaming and I just took 5 days to sleep. Then I woke up. I woke up now and I don't know. I was confusing. Is this really a real things or not? There was a journalist and an Russian woman beside me at the helicopter. She was looking at me and she said, you look not happy. I told her it's not about happy or not happy. I don't know. I need someone to maybe to slap me or something. I cannot believe that I did this. And I really feel there is a many feeling. I feel there was a fear, there was a happy feeling, there was a confusing. I was thinking about my family, about everything. I was thinking about everything, so it was a confusing for me. Then I told her, and even there was tiredness. I don't know from where it came. It was when we was packing everything. I was fully active and fully powered. Just when the helicopter take off, I start to feel tired. I don't know. I want to sleep. Just I want to sleep, and I cannot sleep. I don't know if this trip is real or not. So it was like I want to sleep, but I do want. Lastly, for the last when I came and when I saw my friend, I saw many people are caring about me, and they said you update us on the Facebook and Instagram. Where you have been? I told them I was in the Northland. Yeah, they said, yeah. Is it real you was there or you was like kidding? I told them no. I was there, and for this reason I was disappearing. So after that, many people are supporting me, especially from the Saudi media, and I took totally coverage for 2 months. I was like a pop star in different magazine and even in TV shows, but for me it wasn't my goal. My goal is to do this, to express myself in this things, and to lead the women, and to show the women that yes, I'm a Muslim. Yes, I'm wearing hijab. Yes, I'm a Saudi. Yes, I'm a small. Yes, I'm a woman. But you can do whatever you want, and you can be you can be whatever you want. Just you have to have a small belief in yourself and in your things. I mean, in your skills, and you will achieve. Just you need this belief. So this is my message to the women. Thank you for Arabian Gawa for this opportunity. I really feel honored, and thank you for coming.